Hi, Lyndon Heffernan from the Academy of Off-Road Riding. Got two things we're going to look at right now. First is rocky sections of trail and this nice little creek crossing behind me. With riding rocks, it's really important to stand up, let that suspension work. Your speed is also critical. If you go too fast, you'll deflect off bigger rocks and get bounced maybe off the track and into something bigger like a tree. So you don't want to go too fast, but at the same time, you don't want to go too slow either, because you want your wheels to roll over the rocks and not just stop at each obstacle. So it's first to second gear, fingers on the clutch so you can control the speed of the bike and the engine, and make sure you look ahead for balance. Don't get sucked into looking down at all the rocks on the ground. Keep your vision up and just allow your body to move and just go with the bike. Now, this creek crossing behind us. Creeks are an area where you can really do a lot of damage to your bike. And I guess it's a place where you can do some damage to the environment. So firstly, when you come to a creek, try and make sure you use the correct entry point, use the shallowest line through, and make sure you exit on the proper part of the track. With water, up to about boot height, you should be able to ride through with the right technique. Anything that's above hip height, it's not really a place for a dirt bike to go through, unless you set it up specially like they do for the Camfari in Darwin. The most important thing is to control your speed. If you come into the creek too fast and you hit something that you don't see, you can have a crash and down you go, drown your engine. Not too good for your motorcycle. So come in at a controlled speed. Again, it's like riding rocks. It's first to second gear, and you want to keep your revs up so the bike don't stall. And also remember that when you go into that water, you're going to lose a little bit of speed. So you go in at maybe first to second gear with a little bit of speed, keeping in mind you're going to lose that speed as you hit the water, but you want to keep enough speed, again, so your wheels will go over any rocks or tree roots or anything you find in the water. The speed that you're looking for should push a nice little bow wave away from your front wheel. While you've got that nice little bow wave, you're staying dry, you're pushing the water apart, and you should have enough speed to get over anything that might be hidden in the creek. If you start to get water up over your gloves and over your face, you're going a bit too quick. That might be all right on a hot summer's day, but I wouldn't want to do that in the Victorian High Country in the middle of winter.